Hey guys, Me Like Big Boom here, and welcome to another Made. It's been like 2 weeks, or maybe even three, I don't even know, since the last Made. Basically, I just stopped doing it because I really ran out of mods to showcase in the Unturned community, but as many of you guys know, Nelson added Workshop like 2 weeks ago, and now there are some awesome mods that are popping up in the Unturned community again, so I might be able to start this series up. So I think from now on, I'm basically just going to post Mades every Monday, and if there are any mods, then I'll just skip it, probably put out like a little tweet or something, but as of right now, there are quite a few that I'm excited to showcase, so we're definitely good for the next month or two, but as of right now, today's mod is a completed gun mod that adds three complete, like, custom models, usable guns, shootable. You can use it to kill zombies, three of them, three awesome mods, and they're in my inventory right now. They are awesome. We have, oops, that's the wrong inventory, here we go. We have the Chris, well, actually, it's the Friss V, but, it, you know, it's a Chris Vector, basically. A civilian version of a military submachine gun. It takes this magazine, the FFACP magazine, civilian-grade ammunition for medium firearms. We will shoot that in a bit. Next, we have the FF416, which is like an M416, I'm assuming. A German assault rifle chambered in military ammunition used by many special forces. This is definitely kind of your high-end military assault rifle, definitely competing with like the Maple Strike, if not even better than that. So this is definitely very cool. Next, we have the AK-74U or the FF-74U. I believe this is made by Fiffy, F-I-F-F-E, so that's probably why he's put these little FFs in here, which is pretty cool. So kind of doing a little tribute to the creator of the mod. But anyway, this is the AK-74U, a Russian submachine gun chambered in 7.62 Ranger ammunition, and it just takes a standard Savage magazine, and this just takes the regular military magazines. There aren't any mods with that. So, and then I've also given myself three of these different sights and tactical attachments and grips and all that stuff, so we can try out the guns with all those different things on. But as of right now, let's try out. Let's just do this M416 or this FF416. So when you equip it, it doesn't have a sight on it currently. I'm not sure if that's going to be added in the future, but it'd be kind of nice if there was an FF416 like iron sights. But as of right now, you're going to have to put a sight on it yourself. Luckily, I have a red halo sight. Looks like this when you put it on. Very nice. It just, you put it on and it just looks right. I mean, honestly, it looks like it was meant to be there, which is pretty cool. While we're here, let's just put a vertical grip on, maybe a tac laser. I didn't spawn myself a barrel attachment, though. Let's go in here and kill some zombies. First, let's put on like a 7x zoom scope and test it out at range. So we'll back away and shoot that guy. Dead on accurate. Very cool. It does sound very cool as well. So we'll go back to this for some close range combat. Pachow! Whoa! Where'd he go? I think I just sent him to the moon, but anyway, very cool sounding. I love that sound. That's like my favorite sound. I mean, I'm going to turn it up real quick for you guys. I'm just going to stop talking and I'll have you guys listen to the sound of this gun. All right, there we go. Very cool sounding. I've got four shots left. I guess we can try out a few different shots without anything on it real quick, except for the sight. I believe the recoil won't be affected that much. I mean, it definitely was a low recoil, but I guess we can see how much it is without a grip on it. Doesn't seem too much different. So if we shoot at this, let's say right there, and it goes up to like the bullet hole is just at the bottom of that red halo. Then, God, my dog's barking, sorry. But then we put on the vertical grip. Yeah, it definitely does help a bit. I mean, overall, it just doesn't have much recoil in the first place, but putting on the vertical grip does help a bit, so that's pretty cool. But anyway, that was the M416, or the FF416, however you want to call it. Takes military magazines, as I said earlier, but here's what it looks like. I'm going to drop it real quick so we can look at it in like a complete view, so we can like walk around it and all that stuff. Very cool. Very nice detailed models. Got the even the trigger and everything. Differently colored little pistol grip. like the adjustable stock with the little clips on it for the strap, the eject point on the side. My only complaint on so far on this model is that when you shoot, the eject point sends the bullet directly upwards rather than side, like to the side. So if I shoot, the eject point is right there, but if you shoot, like it goes up. Yeah, that's kind of my only issue with that. Pretty much everything else about this gun is freaking awesome, and I'm loving it. Moving on to the next one, we have the Chris Vector, or the Fris V. So, we equip it. Here's what it looks like. Once again, all of these don't have iron sights equipped on them. Actually, except for the AK-74U, that actually has the standard Zubeknikov sights put on it. But the Vector and the M416, they don't have sights that come on them automatically, so you're going to have to put on one yourself. So here's what it looks like when you put a sight on it, and if you don't have anything, it's just like looking down the rail like that. But we're going to put on vertical grip and tac laser. Very cool. Everything just lines up well. I mean, there's no weird things that's going on. It's kind of weird how the vertical grip is kind of here. If I just take it off real quick, you can see how the vertical grip might be a bit difficult to grab with such a small space in between there. But other than that, looking pretty good. Tac light lines up, everything. It's all mounted on the bottom. Very cool. I kind of wish it would stop glowing so I could see what it looks like when it's not like that. So anyway, that's what it looks like. Once again, these models are detailed, but they're not so overly detailed that they don't look like they're something from Unturned, and that I really like that. I think this is a good detail amount where it's not getting like overly realistic, but it's still looking like Unturned. Kind of see what I'm saying? But anyway, so we will shoot it. One thing to note, it doesn't have a barrel attachment, and I believe that's because it comes automatically suppressed, and I will show you that in a bit. We'll shoot a zombie. All right, here's what it sounds like. It sounds really cool. Like, it's just like a rattling noise. It's just piercing rattle and stuff. It's very cool. I mean, let's shoot it a few more times. By the way, it doesn't come automatic. It's got semi and safety. Anyway, I've shot all my shots. I can actually reload real quick. Yep, it's got all the reload sounds. It doesn't line up quite perfectly. As you can see, the cocking sound didn't happen when the animation lined up, but that can always be fixed. And there we go. We killed all the zombies with this Vector. Very cool. I like it a lot. That sound is very cool. That's a very cool suppressor sound. But anyway, that was the Vector. Now let's move on to the very last one, the AK-74U or the FF-74U. We equip it. This is what it looks like. Pretty interesting. I mean, when you first equip it, you think like, oh, AK, but then it's kind of weird how you don't see the barrel. But once you kind of do this angle, it looks pretty nice. It looks pretty realistic, like the AK. It doesn't have a tactical attachment or a grip attachment. All you can put on it are sights and barrel attachments. It also takes the Ranger magazine. I know before I said Savage, but that was from 2.0. But anyway, now it's called the Ranger magazine. So it takes that. And the Ranger magazines need to be filled by Ranger ammunition. This is what the iron sights look like. Pretty nice. I mean, I don't know. That's just the Zubeknikov sights. They look all right. I definitely put on a sight like this to make it a bit easier to see. And also, 7x zoom scope is what it looks like. Pretty cool. Everything lines up. It's very nice. I'm going to teleport somewhere else so we can find some more zombies to kill. Anyone over here? Yeah, there's a few. All right. Kapow. That's what it sounds like. Very cool. Yeah, let's find some more. All these gun sounds are very nice. I like them. The zombies are coming. This is a two-shot to the head. Got them all. All right, now let's see what fully automatic sounds like, because I got 11 shots left. I'll run after this guy. Lie prone. Got him. One shot left. Here's what we'll do. We'll put it on semi, shoot him in the face, unequip it, and punch it. Haha, worked very nice. Anyway, those are all the shots that I have left on the AK-74U. That pretty much concludes all that I can really show on those guns. But those were the three guns that came in Fifth's firearm pack. Very cool. If I go in shift tab, here's what the Steam Workshop page looks like. Fifth's firearms version 0.1, so it's very early on. But if you guys like to download it, just click on the link down below and it'll bring you to the workshop page for this mod. All you gotta do is just press the subscribe button and it will add it to your game. If something is weird, if it gives you like a 404, you need to join the Unturned Beta Workshop group thing. in order to get access to workshop in the first place, and I will link that down below as well if you guys haven't joined that workshop beta group yet. But anyway, first custom usable mod guns in Unturned. That's freaking awesome. I can't wait to see what other guns we can find in the future, but as of right now, that is all I have for now. Make sure to rate, comment, subscribe, and do all that gibberish, because me like big boom is out.